Biology is important for a couple of reasons. One is, I think most individuals are just naturally curious about where they come from as organisms and where they fit. Another, of course, is in areas such as medicine. Basic research in biology has always informed, you know, any medical advances that we make. It always starts at this level, at basic research. It starts with training of students, and ultimately, may take many years, ends up in things like pharmaceuticals and agriculture and how we treat patients. So my approach to biology is a little bit different because it takes basic physical principles and techniques and applies them to biological problems. Part of that is modeling biological phenomenon theoretically, so there's a theoretical aspect to the work. Other aspects of that are using instrumentation that you normally see applied to physics problems, like in astronomy, for instance. But rather than looking up into the heavens and into the stars, we focus things like microscopes and use the same sort of physical instrumentation to look deep into cells to extract basic information about those cells. So as a cell biologist, we're interested in a couple of different things. One is how molecules are actually interact within cells to function. Some aspects of that research are applied to things like understanding how cells all of a sudden stop to function normally. So there are applications at a very basic level to things like cancer research. Another part of our research focuses on, and for much of my career, in fertilization biology. And the basic question is, how do the two gametes, sperm and eggs, ultimately interact with each other? Understanding how they interact can solve a couple of different problems. One is, you know, if one is infertility, but the other is in developing novel contraceptives.